Welcome back to the walking tour video of Walking Tour Wednesdays. I'm currently at Centennial Collegiate, which is opposite to the street on Nelson Road of Saskatoon. This is a soccer field, and today's walk would involve a walk from Centennial Collegiate to the Forestry Farm Park and then to the Saskatoon Northeast. Sorry, Northwest Swale. Let's begin. It's pretty windy today, so I apologize in advance for the noises. We are now approaching the Forestry Farm Park. This is the entrance way. You see that there's a line of car lining up here, but that is only a route for cars. This is a map of the farm park, I mean the zoo. So you can come in by car, but we're gonna join in on the pedestrian pathways. And our path will continue this way to the right here. This is part of the Meewasin Trail, which is a trail network connecting the South Saskatchewan River to the adjacent neighborhoods. So, a little explanation about swale. It's basically a body of land that used to be a river. So you can think of it as a wetland. And therefore, it has natural values. And that is something unique about the prairie provinces of Canada. So this trail here is somewhat of a recreational trail because it connects you from Forestry Farm Park all the way up to the northwest swale and nearby neighborhoods. We also have a little stopping point at the natural grassland area that is part of this trail. I wonder what this is. If anyone knows in the comments, please let me know. I assume that it's kind of like a water drainage channel, things like that, which is good. Also a form of flood mitigation. Okay, I think I need to stop talking, and yes, I will. Because watching back the old episodes of walking tours, I realize that it's kind of distracting, so I will refrain from making any comments from now. We have now come across a park, which is called Silverspring Park. Wayfinding here, good for telling us where we are. So, the sign does say how long it would take me. It'd be 4 minutes of walking until we hit the grassland, and then another 8 minutes to get to the linear park of the neighborhood. Quick definition of a linear park. So, this and the pocket parks are two types of parks that are small, compact, don't take a lot of space, mainly just to fill in the blanks or like gaps between buildings. It's good for connectivity and some greeneries. I think I should put a second disclaimer is that all the definitions I said in this video are just oversimplified definitions. I will link full descriptions of them in the description, in the bio of this, or like what say, whatever. You see the gate over there? It's kind of hard to see, but we're approaching the Saskatoon Natural Grassland. The path here also downgraded to just a gravel paw path to preserve the naturality and the purity of the area. It's a pretty wide area with a pathway on its edge to continue going forward. I will link information about grassland as well as the natural grassland in the comments or the description. These pathways also do not have lampposts, and I support it. It does not disrupt the lifestyle of the natural ecological systems and animals here. We are leaving the natural grassland. So, we are now officially leaving the natural grassland because we have approached the paved surfaces again. This is kind of like a roundabout for pedestrians because it's a joining point between the linear park, which is this way, and some other pathways to go down towards the neighborhood of Evergreen in Saskatoon. And see if there are like backyards of houses are right here. However, I was about to say that they don't have access, but they to this trail from their back doors, but they do. And you also noticed that the lamppost here are in a newer design compared to the older lamppost in other places, in other trails of the city. That is because this is a very newly built trail, and now we're walking on Silverspring Linear Park. We call it linear because it's literally just a trail like this, but I will leave the definitions if you want to read more about that in the description. Let me just stop here to drink my water. Need to stay hydrated in this weather. We're coming across another roundabout for pedestrians. Although we don't have to go in circle, I still love to call it a roundabout. We're now going up an arterial road called Fedoruk Drive. This is the arterial road of the neighborhood of Evergreen. And on the other side of the road is the swale already. So this arterial road has a sidewalk and also a protected bike path. I have no clue if this is a two-way or one-way bike path. I'm going to assume it's two for North American standards. My European audience is going to be very confused if I say this is a two-way, but for North American standards, I would say that this is good enough for two bikes to bypass each other. The wind is very aggressive out here. I feel like it's pushing me forward. Like I'm not even walking anymore. The wind is pushing me. gonna cross the street here. Side of Fedoruk is also a wide, 3.6 meter wide, mixed use pathway that both bikes and pedestrians can ride on it. Alright, now I gotta go on the opposite direction of the wind. No good. We are now officially in the Northeast Swale. You can see that there is a stormwater retention pond that it has been naturalized. There are some pathways here that are 100% unpaved. It feels very natural in here. Given the ecological values of this area, I sincerely hope that there will be no residential development invading this space. Because wetlands in cities is something already very rare. And again, we as humans need access to nature. I guess this is the end of this walking tour episode. Thank you so much for watching.